Velio. Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included. Hello again, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I was hoping to see you again, my young friend. Gladwyn Moon, Hogwarts caretaker. At your service. First, please allow me to apologize if I seemed a bit unsteady when we last met. I'm afraid I had a rather disconcerting encounter. Although I hear your visit to Hogsmeade was even more eventful than mine.
I suppose you could call it eventful. I certainly wasn't expecting a troll attack.
Oh, of course not! And from what I understand, the village was lucky you were there. In fact, my recent visit to Hogsmeade is the reason I was hoping to bump into you. I could use your help with something. Do you see that curious statue over there? Watch what happens when that light changes from day to night. If you wouldn't mind humoring me for a moment, see if you can remove the moon from the statue. Oh, odd little contraptions, aren't they? It seems the statue vanishes once the moon is removed, which, incidentally, can only be done at night. Why don't you hold on to that one for now, and I'll explain more as we walk. Ever since that fateful day in the village, those curious statues have begun appearing about the castle. A fair number have been strewn around Hogsmeade. Someone, it seems, is trying to torment me. You see, that day in Hogsmeade, I turned a corner and came face to face with a boggart, or shapeshifter, if you will, which takes the form of whatever scares you most. This one took the form of a demiguise.
A demiguise?
Yes, terrifying creature that can see the future. Wholly unnerving. I encountered one when I was a lad in Korea. Terrible experience. Those statues are demiguises. The moons, I assume, are an uninspired play on my name. Some jackanapes used a boggart to learn my greatest fear and use it against me. I have my suspicion as to the scoundrel or scoundrels responsible. It is my hope that they will slip up and reveal themselves as the statues disappear. That is why I need your help in removing the statues.
Why me?
A couple of reasons, frankly. First, your daring do against those trolls in Hogsmeade has gained you a reputation for fearlessness. Second, as macabre and hideous as a demiguise is, most would find my fear of them unwarranted. You, however, have seen how they affect me. I'm at my wit's end, young friend. I simply can't bring myself to go near them. In fact, I know of two statues right here in the faculty tower. Perhaps you could start simply by removing them so I can go about my evening duties.
I'd be glad to help you, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I knew I could count on you. First, you know how to cast a disillusionment charm, correct? You'll want to do that before wandering the tower at night. Next, you'll notice that the door is locked. However will you get in? Alohomora, that's how.
But what about curfew?
Curfew? Oh, tosh! I sense you're a bit like me when I was your age. Oh, the school was my oyster. And I took advantage of it. Oh, everyone loved me for it. Oh, those were the days. Now, you'll find one statue in the prefect's bathroom and the other in the hospital wing. Good luck. Oh, and thank you.
Alohomora.
You're in. Remember, use a disillusionment charm so no one claps eyes on you. This is a restricted area of the castle, after all.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Revelio. Thank you. Avelio. Alohomora. Revelio.
Year.
Rather poorly, I'd say.
Is that so?
We're raising a generation of coddled kidnappers who can scarcely tell the difference between Aconite and Asphodel.
Yes, well, it's still early. Perhaps they'll improve.
You say that every year.
Thank you.
off on another adventure, are we?
Not at the moment, no. Plenty of other perils and pitfalls to send them my way, though. Well, I suppose I should begin my rounds now.
I suppose Professor Black knows best, but the students are terribly disappointed about Quidditch being cancelled. To learn the Quidditch rules.
Velio.
It's a majestic sport. Encompasses the whole of the human condition.
Oh, how's that?
Well, all of the teamwork and flying about and the golden snitch. Rather a lot like life, isn't it?
Oh, I suppose I should pay closer attention in the next match, if there ever is one.
I suppose you should.
Incendio! Excellent!
This must be the prefect's bathroom.
Alohomora.
Revelio.
Stirring up trouble. Perhaps Ranrock and Hyssop wouldn't be so combative if the Ministry would allow them to have wands.
Hello, Amora.
Class is four. Why don't you leave goblins alone, you troll?
How dare you speak to a prefect that way?
I'm a prefect too, you twit.
That's it. 50 health points.
This must be the prefect's bathroom.
In Hogsmeade.
Hello, Mr. Moon. I have the moons you asked me to collect.
Oh, goodness! You're as fearless as I'd hoped. An excellent start. If we can collect more, it may shed some light on who's behind all this. Of course, I first suspected Peeves. He drove the previous caretaker, Rancorous Carp, to an early retirement with his intolerable buffoonery. But that does not explain the boggart in Hogsmeade, does it? No. I am determined, with your help, to discover the identity of my tormentor.
I'll see what I can do, but I'm fairly busy. I can't promise anything.
Understood. But I hope you will find the time. In case it matters, I do have something to offer in exchange for your assistance. Now, remember, the moons are only retrievable at night. Thus, I encourage you to use a disillusionment when necessary.
How many statues are there to find?
I don't know precisely, but I've spotted dozens. Seems they're everywhere I look. You have your work cut out for you, if you were to ever unravel their meaning.
You mentioned offering something in exchange for my assistance.
I did. Once you've brought me enough moons, I'll show you even more powerful forms of Alohomora. Not every lock is as easy to pick as the faculty towers.
Understood. I shall keep an eye out.
I appreciate that. Oh, and I knew you were the one to ask for help. Keep at it so we can solve this mystery.
Thank you.
Revelio.
Hello, Mr. Moon.
Oh, greetings! Any luck removing some more of those demiguise statues?
I actually have some moons for you.
Oh, thank you. The fewer of these statues I see, the better. You keep your eye out for others, and I'll teach you more about Alohomora.
Where should I look for more demiguise statues and moons?
All of my usual haunts, which incidentally have now become quite haunting. Here in the castle, in Hogsmeade, and believe it or not, in some of the surrounding hamlets. Oh, my tormentor is nothing if not thorough. Kept me from all my usual engagements for an eternity now.
I'll keep an eye out for more demiguise statues and see if I can bring you more moons.
You are to be commended for your bravery and valor, especially since they can only be collected at night.
Ravenia. Revelio. Revelio. Alohomora.
Revelio. What are you up to now? Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Revelio. Lumos. Velio. Alohomora. Alohomora. Revelio.
I had said I would.
You should ask her.
I can't hold my breath for that.
No.
I'm going to ask her this time.
You said that 40 years ago.
Revelio.
Did you see that? She looked at me.
My dear Mounder's shoulders, I'm afraid of.
I'm going to do it.
You should, before the next century.
Oh, for heaven's sake, get on.
The lady, would thou takest my hand in dance?
Oh.
I did it. I asked her.
Forgetting anything?
No. Oh, goodness. Milady, might I borrow my body, perchance? Milady?
Care to dance?
Thought you'd never ask.
Revelio. Revelio.
The ghost.
Why did I never learn how to swim?
Incendio! Revelio.
I'd sink like a stone.
Going for a swim?
Goodness, no. Though I'm beginning to think I really should learn how to swim. Can't very well be liaison to the merpeople if I don't know how to swim.
You're a liaison to the merpeople?
Well, not technically, no. At least not yet. The position doesn't actually exist at the moment, but I have a plan to change that. I'm Nerida, by the way. Nerida Roberts. We didn't officially meet, but we duelled in the Crossed Wands Club.
Yes, of course. Good to see you again.
And you.
You seem quite interested in merpeople.
I am. And they're as misunderstood and disregarded by wizard kind as goblins and centaurs are. I feel that if goblins and centaurs have liaison officers at the Ministry, then the merpeople should have one too.
I'm impressed. I think reaching out to the merpeople is a grand idea.
You do? Oh, thank you. Of course, I haven't exactly done anything just yet. I presented them with a gift a few weeks ago, and they wanted to leave me one as well, in one of their caves. Reciprocity and an offer to visit. I tried telling them I couldn't swim, but I'm afraid that bit got lost in translation. Mermish really is tricky.
How has wizardkind fallen short in its treatment of merpeople?
Well, we've consistently deigned merpeople as being beneath us despite the many similarities between our cultures. One can hardly blame them for declining being status by the Ministry years ago. Who are we to classify those of such beauty and intelligence?
What do you imagine a liaison to the merpeople would do?
Oh, so many things. I want to know everything I can about them. After I've mastered swimming, I'd perfect my mermish, of course, and I'd share with them anything they wanted to know about wizardkind. My hope is that by understanding each other better, both of our societies could grow.
What is it about the merpeople that interests you so much?
I can't begin to tell you how brilliant they are. I mean, rumor is that tales about them have infiltrated even the Muggle world. The oldest known merpeople, sirens, come from Greece. And of course, Scotland has Selkies and Ireland is home to Merrows. I could go on for ages about them. Their glorious underwater communities, domestication of sea life, their art and music. It's a travesty how little is understood about them.
Well, I can swim and could help you if you'd like.
You'd really do that? Oh, thank you! Thank you, thank you! The last thing I want is for them to think I'd shunned their gift. Diplomacy is a delicate dance. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I think you can dive down to their cave from just there in the water. I can't wait to hear about what you find. One day soon, I'll see for myself. I just know it.
Look at this place. Did the merpeople really leave Nerida an artifact? Revelio. Lumos. Incendio! Now then, I'll need you to come with me. Now for the rest of you. Will be happy about this. Your gift from the Merpeople was exactly where they said it would be.
Oh, that's wonderful news! I was so worried I'd left it too long and they'd seen it as a slight. Our relationship with them is already so tenuous.
Then I'm glad we helped to foster some healthy diplomatic relations.
Merlin's beard! It's marvelous! I'm going to show it to everyone, including the Ministry! Should I hand deliver or send by owl? Thank you again, so much. You may have just helped improve relations between wizardkind and merpeople for decades to come. I can't wait to study this.
Revelio.
Do not dally, young friends. Fortune waits not for the slothful. Stand back, you knaves. No, you're not.
Revelio.
I haven't been called Puffskeen Dunkin' once since you brought me that venomous tentacular leaf. I think I am actually braver.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
Professor Howen was carrying some help.
Revelio. Lumos.
Since you brought me that venomous tentacular leaf. I think I am actually braver.
Revelio. Nice to see you, my young friend.
Revelio.
Alohomora. Revelio.
What do we have here? A demiguise.
My
mind now, demiguys. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
Ravenia. Revelio. Lumos.
Yes, I told you. You're very clever.
Clever? How offensive. Next.
Fine, a genius.
Revelio.
What if he sticks like this?
What? Don't be silly. It'll wear off in a few hours, I think.
You think?
It didn't before. That's